they came out beautiful. But we went through that tough time of working out payment plans to everybody. Because we were not being paid. And yet we had decided to pay out this debt. So each person we had to pay, we worked out a plan, we pay you per month so much. And it was tough, but it worked out. And then we got lucky, we got shares of Google, we got a Google. We got shares of Google stock before it went public. That helped us a lot. That helped us clean all our balance sheet, all our things. We could pay everybody and then sell the company nicely. Everything worked because of that hanging in there. And we just settled. Google had no name at that. And one of the people who owed us money, one of the companies, they had shares of Google stock. And they said, we'll give you that share, those shares. Take these shares, we don't have the money. So we said, okay, we'll take a gamble.
Whatever we can give.
Anybody can give. Yeah. And that's true to be very good. So you never know. It's always wise to sometimes take it. You take what you're getting. Because you will not get that out.
Yeah.
And you never know, sometimes they work out for you. In our case, it did. But sometimes those things may not work out. The other thing you have to know is how to face adversity. How to face, somebody gives you a bill and you don't believe you have to pay them that bill. How do you work it? But they believe you have to pay them. They believe that. I'll give you an example. We had a former partner whom these people had paid his money, his share, paid for much. But there was a lawsuit that the company had when that man was a CFO. Those people put a lawsuit against him personally and the company also. So the company's lawsuit, I had to deal with because I had taken over as the CFO. So I told them we'll settle out of court with that other company. So these guys were a little hesitant. They said, how will we settle out? I mean, it's not very common to settle out of court. In the US, everything goes to court. I said, no, we'll talk to them. So we reasoned with them that we will not badmouth them and they will not badmouth us. And we will give them a non-compete and do some of the legal things so that we don't affect their business. That is all they were worried about. That is what I realized when I understood what happened. This was all happening before I joined you. So I told them that I've understood what their problem is. Let us write out certain things we will not do to offend them. Their right, and we will not hurt them. We won't talk bad about them. Let them not talk bad about them. They have more to lose if we talk bad because they are bigger than them. So the bigger person, the best way to take care of them is to tell them you will hurt them through media. I have done that in India also. If in India somebody has taken money and they have not completed the project, you just start an internet campaign. The bigger group there, it costs them more.
Reputation is
so much more that they will normally settle. I have done that in India with one group. Well, I didn't have to go to the internet. I threatened them with that and they backed off. It does work. They know the cost there is more. It's finally an economics thing. If that going to the price for the reputation, is it more than this money or to this guy, then we pay this. It is not because you are right or anything, because for them it's more economical to settle with you. Right? Now this guy, who was the CFO before, he was told by my partners, you also settle out of court. We have settled out of court and we are comfortable. He took it as an ego issue. He said, no. They have no business sending, fighting with us. I'm going to go through a lawyer. So he went through a lawyer. That lawyer sent him a bill for $9,000, which he sent us, saying you guys have to pay it because the company was there and that's why I got it. So these guys got mad because they said, we told that fool not to fight. We also would have fought like that with them. No. We didn't fight because of this lawyer legal action. We are not going to pay him a dime, so you tell him we are not paying him anything. So this was a problem. How do you deal with this guy? Was very adamant that he needs this $9,000 to pay his lawyer. And my partners were clear, this guy is a jerk, go pay him anything. He thinks no end of himself, all that jerk talk. So three of us were to go for that meeting. On that day, I decided the other two were too angry. So I told them, you guys don't come, I'm going to come. So I said, this anger is not going to work here. Because this guy, it's not going to work, but he's far too intelligent. He's an IIT Bombay graduate. So I said, he's a very intelligent man, you can't defeat him with trying to tell him you're messed up and this. Because he keeps sending notices and it's just be a waste of our time. So they said, what will you tell him? Because everybody likes to know as partners what you're going to tell. I said, I have no idea because I don't know this guy. So they said, no, but if you have a game plan, tell us. I said, I have no game plan because I don't know this guy. It will have to happen when I'm sitting in front of you. But one thing I want from you all though is that if I give you a commitment, you will stick to it. Trust me that I will protect you. But that much trust you should have in me. But I don't know what I'm going to do. So after a lot of thinking, they finally gave it. So okay. So I went in. I met this guy and I've never forgotten this because it was really strange. He had a lot to say, because he was very angry. He was a partner with this guy, and things did not work out, and he broke off on his own, doing some software consulting, doing all those things. So he had a lot to say. And I decided I'd be very quiet. So I had a paper and a pad, and I just heard. I kept eating that pizza and drinking that coke and everything, and just heard. For 2.5 hours, he only spoke. I kept on writing. In the middle, I was writing some more and eating my pizza. After he finished everything, I asked him, have you finished? He said, yes, I finished. And he said, what do you think? I said, first thing is, we'll not give you a time. You're not getting any money. So he said, oh. I said, yeah, because your problem is not money. Your problem is cash flow. You're not really greedy for this $9,000. Your problem is, he told me he was coming to Bombay for a visit and